I go to the gym, I train pretty hard, I'm always doing upper body, and the boys always come up to me and tell me, bro, you're the biggest leb, you've got to start doing legs, you can't just do upper body, you know what I mean? I'll go, all right, no, but I don't need to do legs, legs are for running, I don't run, don't worry about that, I don't run, you know what I mean? So my question is, do you have to do legs at the gym to get like bigger, you know what I mean?
Surprisingly, it flows through from one part of the body to the other. Now, think about people who are really good at running, like Usain Bolt and all those other sprinters who can cover 100 metres in a very short time. And then just compare their upper body and their lower body. Their upper bodies are huge.
All in comparison. All in comparison.
So they've got huge upper bodies and their lower bodies are not as good as a marathon runner. So really, your friends have got something going for them. You need to have a balance all the way through. And what you're doing of putting on muscle now is good. And it used to be thought that inevitably your muscle mass would drop as you got older. But if you keep on pumping iron, it doesn't. Oh, my God, what a surprise. So, look, go for both. Do upper body and lower body. And you'll find surprisingly that your lower body development will help your upper body get a bit harder and stronger.
That's it. Beautiful. Thanks, Dr. Carl. You're a machine. I've seen your picture this morning.
Everybody is loving that hunky old photo of Dr. Carl.